Hey guys, welcome to KK Java Tutorials. In this video tutorial, we'll talk about stored procedure or function parameter modes in Oracle. Yeah. So first of all, we'll understand all the concept, and finally we'll explore those things through an example as well. Yeah. So here, PL SQL supports three parameter modes for procedure or function. Yeah. Those three parameters is, first is in. This is the default mode. In parameters allow the calling code to pass values into the procedure or function, right? So even though if you pass input parameter, in is basically default. If you do not specify, then that will consider as in means input parameter. Now second is the out. This parameter allow the procedure or function to pass values back to the calling code. Yeah. Now finally we have a in out. That's the combination of both in and out. This parameter allow the calling code to pass values into and receive values from the procedure or function. So now let's try to understand these three modes of procedure or function using example, various example, right? So here is the SQL developer. So let's be the in parameter. So if you look into my this stored procedure, so this stored procedure whose name is welcome message, takes message and input and same is going to return. So this contains only input parameter. In means input. Even though if you remove this one, this is gonna work. So this is the default this is the default name of your input your parameter. So if you do not specify in or out explicitly, then this will consider as a input parameter. Okay, so I'm not going to change this stored procedure. Let's call this stored procedure, right? So I'm going to call this stored procedure welcome message, which accepts one input parameter. Yeah, so I would say execute procedure name, and here I'll pass a message, any message you can pass. I'm going to pass hello, and let's execute. So here you can see this is returning a same message, hello, right? So this is an example of basically input parameter. Now let's see an example where in and out both could have been used, right? So here you can see I have created a procedure with in and out, right? So this is first parameter name is an input parameter, and second parameter is called welcome message out parameter. So this is very simple procedure where this out parameter just I'm concatenating welcome, and this whatever name is coming in the input parameter, so that if you pass KK, then this will print welcome KK, right? And same we are printing in the DBMS output. So let's see how we can call this stored procedure which contains in and out. So to call this guy, I would declare, first of all I'm going to I have to declare one anonymous basically PL SQL block. So declare inside a declare, then I would say begin and end, right? So here inside this I'm going to call this guy with this parameter. Let's say KK is the input parameter, output parameter just I'm going to whatever name you want you can give. I'm going to give this one. It's not mean that you have to give this name, you can give anything, but this parameter you have to declare first in declaration section. So I would say this, and I would say worker saying let's say 100. That's it. Whatever parameter you are out parameter you are using, first of all you have to declare. If I run, then let's see output. So here saying welcome KK is coming, right? So here in this procedure you have seen how to use in and out parameter. Now let's see another example where we can use in out parameter, right? So for that already I have created a procedure is called, yeah, so somewhere I had created procedure, let me rephrase. Okay, so this you can see swap number, right? This is a stored procedure which basically swapping two numbers. So here you can see first number is called X. This is declared as in out both. So this means X, this and X and Y both has been declared X in and out, and both has a number data type is number, right? So both can accommodate as input as well as output number. Now in our declaration section, when you create a stored procedure, right? You don't need to declare a declare keyword in declaration section, right? How you declare in PL SQL block, anonymous block. Now here, this is the basically logic has been written for swapping these two numbers, right? So we have a temporary number. Now in T, we are assigning this first number. Then in second number, in first number, we are assigning second number. And then second number, we are assigning this temporary variable which currently holding a first number. So this way we are just doing kind of swapping. Now how to call this kind of a stored procedure? So here already I have written, again you have to write basically anonymous block, right? So in declaration section, in A I have assigned 3, B I have assigned 8, right? So my expectation is to swap this number. So now once I call this stored procedure swap number by passing A and B, then A should contain 8 and B should contain 3. Let's see. And just we are calling this stored procedure and we are just I'm printing value of A and B, right? So here whether you are putting capital and a small denominator, let me put A. Yeah. Now if I run, then you'll see the output. Here you can see now output is printing the DBMS output. A is now holding 8 and B is holding 3. Now this swapping is working perfectly fine. So guys, here you have seen how to make use of in out or parameter mode, right, which is accommodating both input and output both, right? So that's all I have in this video tutorial, guys. Big thank you and see you there in the next video tutorial.